All right. Thanking the Lord for another beautiful day, a blessed day. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. I want to give a great shout out to everybody. The title of this video is Playing with Confidence. I want to talk to the musicians for a minute. It don't matter what instrument you play. Playing with confidence. And let's say this off top. Everybody are different. Some are beginners. Some been playing for years. Some are in the middle. And we have to learn that. We really have to learn that everybody is on different levels, because we all had to go through that stage as a beginner musician. And when you talk about playing with confidence, and I had a good question about doing this video, big shout out to you, Chris, on this video. And I know what you mean when people come up to you with songs, let's say some of these singers, they come up to you and they think you supposed to know how to play everything because you play by ear. Now, they gotta be careful with that. And you gotta be careful with that also. Let me tell you why. Because this is the biggest mistake I see all time. And I see people do this in all pretty much every church I go to, when they come up to you saying, "Just catch me." And they supposed to be so skillful, but everybody ain't that skillful. And they'll even tell you what key they in. And when you give them the key, they don't know what the key is. They might say, "Oh, brother, I sing in A flat." And really, they don't know what key they sang in. They be in the key of Z. And when you sitting there in front of everybody, then the ball is in your corner, everybody looking at you and expecting you to know that song. Well, first of all, you playing by ear. Second of all, let me say it like this, and I mean this out of love. It's better for a keyboard player to don't play the song at all. It's just my opinion. Don't play the song at all than to sit there and look stupid and mess the singer up when the singer's already messed up. So it don't make sense for both people to mess up, especially if you ain't never heard this song before. This is what I do. And people always tell me, "Well, JT, you know how to play everything." No, I don't. If I knew how to play everything, I wouldn't even be trying to learn so much. I will sit there and say, "You know what? I don't know this song, and I'm not finna mess you up." And I'd rather just sit here and look. I just sit here. And when I sit there, I'm still confident in myself. You know why? Because you got to learn that you don't want to mess folks up. And then some of these singers need to learn that you are not all that skillful like you think you are. And then they get the floating keys and singing flat. And now you looking like you really don't know how to play. See, I cut all that out, but that's just me. Now, some musicians might stumble through a song. Now, it's different if I know the song. That's why I always listen to them real close. I said, what's the name of the song? And if they blurt out something I don't know, I tell them to sing it a cappella. And then you got some people sitting in the congregation saying, "Man, that man don't know how to play." Now, it ain't the fact that you don't know how to play. It's the thing is you being respectful and you don't want to mess yourself up or the singer. See, we got to learn how to start doing things in decent and in order. That's why I say when you play with confidence. But see, you got to build that confidence up. That's why practice is so important. That's why transpose the keyboards, they stay mad at me, because they know I don't transpose. And I'm not saying that to brag or boast. I don't need no hand clap. They stay mad at me because they know when I come into church, I'm not finna put no keyboard on transpose. And here's the other thing about this transposing. Boy, you'll make yourself look like a fool. And then you can make others look like a fool, because I learned if I'm coming up behind somebody, the first thing I do before I touch the keys is pray. And then I check to see if that joker is set on zero. Because, I mean, you will start off a song and you be 7-8 keys higher than where you're supposed to be. But let's get back to talking about playing with confidence. See, once you start getting to that level and start playing in them different keys, see, this is the problem with most musicians when they get in the church and somebody starts singing, or even if they know the song, "I hope they do it in A flat." That's what you be saying in your mind. "I sure hope they do this song in A flat or E flat." And then they get on there and they jump in the key of E. You don't even want to play. Or they get in the key like A natural. You don't want to play. See, you got to start getting in all these keys. When I get on the keyboard, I don't care what key the song is in. The problem is too many people want to hit fat chords in every key. Let me tell you something about fat chords, people. Fat chords ain't what make you a piano player. Discipline, humbleness. You can take a regular C chord and make it just as effective when you use a different bass line with it. It's not about hitting fat chords all the time. If you hit them, fine. But I got to make this point because most people don't want to play in certain keys because they can't do in E what they do in A flat. They want to hit these magical chords. And some people be praying that the songs always in A flat and E flat. See, I'm tired of playing in A flat. This is me. I am tired of A flat. I'm tired of E flat. And I'm tired of C sharp. Those are the keys that most gospel songs are going to be in, especially A flat. I can give you a long list of songs. The original key is going to be A flat. You got to start getting these keys like D, D natural, E, B, which don't nobody like playing in B. That's why I say A. You got to start getting in those in those keys also. That's what help you get greater. So when you start playing with confidence, and people start coming up to you and want you to play, after a while, you're going to know a lot of them songs. And then if they're going to say, well, can you put it in a higher key for me? You ain't got to look for that transpose button. You transpose in your mind. This is a real transpose up here, knowing them scales, knowing those keys that if you in C, you can do the same thing in C sharp. You just going up a half step, you should know. See, you should be able to get to the point in your mind, but I'm saying everybody are on different levels. But to the ones that are getting there and been playing for years, see, you shouldn't be still playing for years and just playing in A-flat and E-flat and C-sharp. You should have been learned how to go through all keys. This is why it is so important to practice, man. It's so important. That way your confidence, you get in the key like E, you be like, man, I've been working on that key. I like E now, man. E is beautiful, man. Most old school songs are in the key of E. Most of them. You can go from Gap Band to Earth, Wind & Fire to a lot of them artists back then. Most of them songs was in the key of E. This is how I learned E so well, not church music. I pretty much learned the key of E off of old school music. Frankie Beverly and Maze, Marvin Gaye. Like I say, the Elements, Gap Band. I learned so many songs in the key of E that I got to the point where I learned E like A flat. I got sick of the key of C. But my point I'm making is learn your craft. That way you will be confident. Because truth be told, a lot of people that come up to you, they can't sing. But you can always be on your game as a musician, whether you playing the keyboard, the bass. I hate when I see this all the time, man, when people just destroy a song. And then you got them people that really can't sing, and then you'll get a band that mess them up. That's why I say it's best to not play at all. Than to stumble through a song. Because one thing you doing when you trying to figure out a song and hitting all these wrong notes, think about the person that's singing. That's going to cause them to hit wrong notes. And some of them are already hitting wrong notes. And then next thing you know, you just got confusion up there. So when anybody walk up to me, you had a question asking me that. When anybody walk up to me and they ask me about a song and I don't know the song, JT will sit there. Because I don't read the piano music. I don't read piano music. I play by ear, and I've been playing for a long time. I'm saying that not to boast and brag. I'm saying that I've been playing all this time, and I still don't know everything about the piano, and I never will. Because when I look at the piano, I look at the Word of God also. I can study all day, every day, and I still won't know everything about the Word of God. When I started learning, it was through trial and error. But I started learning, and I started messing. You know what I do sometimes when I come in here and practice? I mess up on purpose. That's how I have found some of my smoothest chords, by messing up. But see, I do my messing up at home. I don't go to church to mess up. I try to be on point when I get to church. That way people can say, that man know what he doing. So when you playing with confidence, how else you gonna build your confidence level? Because if you don't have confidence in yourself, it's going to be hard for you to make it through your instrument. You have to have confidence in yourself. I talk to piano players all the time. It's amazing to me how many of them want to give up because they want to learn the piano overnight. Can you believe me, the man out of everybody I used to teach, everybody has quit? Everybody. When I'm teaching individually, going to people's house or people come to my house, everybody quit because they can't get their first stage, me, the man. They gave up. And I said, if I was to give up, I wouldn't be here teaching you right now. And I try to explain to people, you don't learn this piano overnight. You don't learn the word of God overnight. You could be around here another 50,000 years and you still won't know all about the word of God. I look at the piano the same way. So what do? I try to learn as much as I can. You got to challenge yourself. That's how I build my confidence level up. And then after a while, you don't be cocky, but you be confident in yourself. Somebody come up to you and say, well, give me Amazing Grace in the key of B. Then you say, okay, you go to B. Then they say, well, that's, you know what, let me change that. Let me go to the key of E natural. Give me Amazing Grace in E natural. You should know how to do it. So you should start wanting to get in them keys that don't nobody like playing in. Because I'm just being honest and blunt when I say this. Most musicians I know, they only play in A-flat, E-flat, and C-sharp. That's it. Some might get in the key of G, but that's it. They play in probably 3 or 4 keys, and you got 12 keys on the piano. And you just limit yourself to just 1, 2, 3 keys? Something wrong with that. This is what me and Mini Man was talking about on the blog talk radio. We got all these cocky musicians out here requesting $400-$500 a Sunday, Psalm 600-700 and up, but you only playing in 3 or 4 keys. And the pastor wants you to go down to the key of D on the organ, and you can't transpose the organ, so you make up excuses. At least if you're going to tell people how much you're worth, at least match up to your plan. That's all I'm saying. And I don't have nothing against nobody. I just tell the truth. We all should be building up our confidence. You got to play with confidence. And if you make a few mistakes, oh, well, I mess up all the time on Sunday mornings a lot of time because I got to sing and play all the time. I hate singing and playing, but I don't have a choice in so many ways. So when I'm singing, I'm always accidentally hitting the wrong note. But you know what I do? The confidence that I have in myself, I laugh it off and I keep going. You know why? Because I'm not worried about what mankind say. My praise is to the Lord. Playing and singing ain't easy all the time, is it, Mini Man? Because you trying to play and not mess up with your playing, and then you trying to sing and not mess up with your vocals, and I be having to direct. So that just is a whole lot on you when you got to sing, play, and direct, and you got this hand doing this, and then you're in the microphone saying it. That takes a lot of concentration, and a lot of people can't do that. I try my best to do it. I ain't all that good in it. I wouldn't say I'm great with it, but it takes a lot out of me because when I sing a song, I really want to focus on vocals. I want to be confident in my singing as well as being confident in my playing. So the word for this morning is playing with confidence. And the sad thing is, hardly don't none of these people that's been playing want to show you nothing, beginner musicians, and I hate that with a passion. Guy asked me on a comment the other night, when you gonna ever come back to YouTube, JT? I don't know. See, I'm still following what the Lord say. I never follow what man say. So with that being said, man, play with confidence. And if you just started out, get there. Practice, practice, practice. I always tell people, practice don't make me perfect. It just make me better. Because I still mess up on plenty of things. I'm not a perfect piano player. I don't claim to be the best, and I never will. There's some cats out here draw circles around me 2 times. But when it comes to that anointing, they can't touch me. And I mean that out of love. I'm not worried about how cold somebody is. It's a lot of cold folks out here. When it comes to being humble and creative and having that anointing, that outtops any keyboard player who think they got all the cards in the world. That's why I'm not intimidated. Here's the other thing. Don't be intimidated by nobody. But you got to get, I know you got to build your confidence up. I don't care who I come behind or who I'm opening up for. First of all, I'm not in it for a performance. I'm in it for a praise. With that being said, God bless you and God keep you. Build your confidence up. Don't be scared.